Hello, Tube Buddies. In this video, we'll teach you how to optimize a video for YouTube. Since YouTube is the second largest search engine in the world, it's important that your videos are properly optimized for YouTube so they'll show up in search results. This process is called search engine optimization, or SEO for short. When your content shows up in YouTube search results, it helps your videos get discovered, earning you views, watch time, and subscribers. Remember, it's the quality of your content that keeps people watching, but SEO is what helps get people's feet in the door. We're gonna show you how we optimize a YouTube video here at TubeBuddy using some of our favorite TubeBuddy tools. Just a heads up, Keyword Explorer, Tag Lists, and Insta Suggest are all accessible in the free versions of TubeBuddy, but for unlimited results, you'll need a pro or higher level license. When it comes to optimizing a video, the first thing we recommend is researching a topic. This is an important step to make before creating the video. That way you know if there's an audience interested in the content that you're creating. Using TubeBuddy's Keyword Explorer, you can see what people tend to type into the search bar, which will help you craft your video around what people are actually looking for. We're currently working on a video that helps you update your existing content, so if you want to be notified about that video, consider subscribing and hitting that bell notification icon to stay up to date on all things TubeBuddy. When determining where to place your video in YouTube search results, YouTube looks at three main pieces of metadata. First, it prioritizes a video's title. Then it looks at the video's description, and finally, it looks at the video's tags. For our research purposes, we will determine the title and tags together, so we can then enter in those tags or keywords into our video's description. Let's open Keyword Explorer and explore a topic. Your video's topic can be on a multitude of things. If you're a gamer, it's the game you're playing. If you have a review-based channel, it could be on the latest thing you plan to review. Or, if you're a travel vlogger, it could be the destination you plan to go to. Anything in your video that helps give it a key focus is key when it comes to optimization. Let's say you're going to be traveling to the San Diego Zoo. We'll type in our key focus of the video into the Keyword Explorer. In this case, the San Diego Zoo. You'll see that even as we type, the Keyword Explorer is making suggestions based on what people are looking for. Once you enter the term you want to research, you'll see the term's overall score, related topics people are searching for around this topic, and then the most used tags in the top-ranking videos on the subject. The score here shows you how well this keyword will likely perform. We know that users in the past have had a hard time differentiating between weighted and unweighted scores. So if you'd like to learn the difference, check out that card on screen now, but come back to this video to continue optimizing your content. With a score like this, we probably shouldn't use this as our video's main keyword. Instead, let's take a look at the related search section to find other things people are searching for. Here we can see things like San Diego Zoo Safari Park and San Diego Zoo versus Safari Park. We recommend long-tail descriptive keyword phrases because they can help you show up in search. Single word tags are too broad, and people don't usually type things into search like this. San Diego, Zoo, Safari, or Park to find information about a subject. The information we research should help shape the content of our video. That's because with TubeBuddy's Keyword Explorer, we can now see what people are searching for. In this instance, we know that making a video comparing the two parks would be really great. We also see that people searching for this content are trying to find things to do with their children in mind at the parks. So maybe if it makes sense for our channel, we do something that focuses around what children can do in the parks. Again, it's our job as YouTube creators to create the content, but also keep in mind ways that it can be searchable and discoverable. For example, let's say we want to talk about the San Diego Zoo bus tour.
Looking at the difference, this term is a lot easier to go after, as you can see with the score on screen. A green score is like a green light at a traffic light. We're good to go. Now that we decided to cover the bus tour at the San Diego Zoo, we should create an appropriate title and find tags that are relevant. So we'll create a tags list right within the Keyword Explorer. We'll go over to Action and then select New Tag List here. We'll call it San Diego Bus Tour Video. That way we can save keywords for later when we're uploading the video. We'll have them ready to go, saving us a lot of time. We also have an option to add this to our video topic planner, so if you don't have time to research it now, you can have all this information for later. For this example, we'll add San Diego Zoo Bus Tour Route to the tags list we just created. We selected this tag because of how similar it is to our topic. You want your tags to be similar to your topic and title, and to rephrase what your title is trying to get across in different ways, while also staying as close to the original as possible. More examples that will work well for this video are San Diego Zoo Bus Tour First Time, or San Diego Zoo Bus Tour Vlog, and things of that nature.
Let's say that our video is done being created and it's now time for upload. We want to show you the power of TubeBuddy Suggested Tags. First, let's determine our title. Since the Keyword Explorer showed us that people are searching for the phrase San Diego Zoo Bus Tour, we want to be sure to incorporate that exact phrase, including those same words in the same order. One thing we see creators do is get results for something like San Diego Zoo Bus Tour, and then they try to title it My Bus Tour of the San Diego Zoo. That's a completely different search term and target with different search ranking results. You need to focus on exact words, exact order. That's what you want to do. YouTube reads titles like us Westerners read English, from left to right in order of most importance. So our title would read San Diego Zoo Bus Tour. And the second half would be to entice the viewer to click on the video. So maybe something like this: San Diego Zoo Bus Tour, what you need to know. That way our searchable bit is within the beginning, and the part that will entice the viewer to click is at the end. You can separate your title to help make it easier to read using a few different types of dividers. You can use a hyphen, like we did, or even a vertical bar like this. A tip when using dividers in your title is that YouTube reads right through it. For example, a title like San Diego Zoo Bus Tour Information would still be optimized for San Diego Zoo Bus Tour. Now that we have our title, we can import our tags list. You'll see that TubeBuddy Suggested Tags will update based on what we have in our title and within our tag box. Now we can decide which tags to add as long as they are relevant to our video and that they are similar to our video's title. Once we add the tags, we're going to build our description using our tags and title. Remember, YouTube gives us 500 characters to use as tags, so try to use as much of the 500 characters as possible for tags and make sure that those tags are relevant to your video. It's important to remember that YouTube first looks at a video's title, then the video's description, and finally the video's tags. Now that we have our tags and title, we can organically include those tags into our video's description. You also want to be sure and focus on the first 200 characters in a video's description, since that's where YouTube looks for the searchable data. Some people place links in the first 200 characters of a description, but they really should go after the fold, or the line after the first 200 characters. That way you're giving YouTube data to work with, and you can also make sure in the video that people know to click the Read More on YouTube. Here is what the description for our example would look like. We do a San Diego Zoo bus tour. What you need to know about the San Diego Zoo bus tour is that it's a lot of fun to see the San Diego Zoo Safari Park in such a unique light. You can see that the description 1 restates our title, 2 includes our tags, and finally, will help us get discovered in YouTube search. Now you have some great ways to better optimize your videos so they'll be surfaced and discovered in YouTube search results. In addition to incorporating the right tags into your title and description, with Keyword Explorer, you can find topics people are searching for before you ever create the video. This way you can create better content that has a higher chance of being discovered within YouTube search, and most importantly, speaks to your ideal viewer. SEO on YouTube can be challenging, but using tools such as TubeBuddy can help you find better keywords and titles so your videos can be discovered in YouTube search. What would you like to know about YouTube search? Let us know in those comments below, and if you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing to TubeBuddy to learn more about how to grow on YouTube. I'm Andrew Cam from TubeBuddy, and thank you so much for watching.